Liberty Process.
This is an instructional disassembly and assembly video for the Liberty Process Equipment APM44 Close Coupled Progressive Cavity Pump. This pump is sometimes called a Wobble Stator pump. The same pump disassembly procedures are also used for Liberty Process APM pump sizes 15, 22, and 33. For pump sizes APM 56 and APM 67, please refer to those specific pump disassembly videos and instruction manuals. Here we will fully demonstrate the complete disassembly of the APM44 Progressing Cavity Pump. While repairing, disassembling, or installing the pump, we recommend using the Operations, Maintenance, and Installations Manual for the Liberty AP and APM series pumps and reviewing them before starting any repairs. These are available for view or downloadable at www.libertyprocess.com. These manuals contain the full information on how to properly assemble and disassemble and how to safely operate your Liberty Progressive Cavity APM series Wobble Stator pump. Before we begin, if the pump has been used, we recommend that you have flushed and drained the pump of all pump mediums and have a clean repair surface on which to work. Tools required for the APM44 pump disassembly: two 7/16 inch wrenches for pump casing bolts, a 9/16 inch wrench for pump motor mounting bolts, a 3/16 and 7/64 inch Allen wrench, and a flathead screwdriver. Disassembly of the APM44 progressing cavity pump. For ease of disassembly, stand pump on motor end and secure on a workbench. Using the pair of 7/16 inch wrenches, begin by removing the pump foot bolts and remove the pump mounting foot if one is installed. Then remove the rest of the 6 bolts on the suction and discharge casings. Once the casing bolts are off, you can lift the suction casing off the pump, exposing the pump stator. Check the casing for debris and clean if necessary. Using both hands, remove the pump stator from the pump by lifting it vertically off the pump rotor. The pump rotor, flex joint, and shaft mechanical seal will now be exposed. Insert the 7/64 inch Allen wrench to use as leverage and lock the stub shaft for ease in removing the pump rotor. Unscrew the rotor counterclockwise from the flex joint. Leaving the 7/64 Allen wrench in the stub shaft, use the 3/16 inch Allen wrench and place it into the end into the top of the pump flex joint. Turn counterclockwise to remove the flex joint from the pump stub shaft. Should the flex joint remain threaded to the rotor when the rotor is removed, simply grip the rotor firmly, insert the 3/16 inch Allen wrench into the flex joint, and rotate counterclockwise. Remove the spring from the discharge casing. Using the 9/16 inch wrench, unscrew the 4 bolts on the pump discharge casing from the motor mounting flange and lift the discharge casing off the motor. The rotating face and the stationary face of the mechanical seal assembly will still be installed in the pump discharge casing. Removing the pump discharge casing from the motor will slide the rotating face of the mechanical seal assembly off the stub shaft, making the rotating face easier to remove. Once the pump discharge casing is separated from the motor, you can remove the rotating face of the mechanical seal assembly. Turn the pump discharge casing over. Using your fingers, press out the stationary face of the mechanical seal. If it remains stuck, use a flat-bladed screwdriver to gently pry it loose. Loosen and remove the set screws from the pump stub shaft. Remove the pump stub shaft from the motor shaft. You have now completely disassembled your Liberty APM44 Wobble Stator pump. Assembly of the APM44 pump. Make sure the pump motor is on the table and secure. Place pump stub shaft on the motor shaft and seat. Tighten with 7/64 inch hex keys. Lubricate the outer diameter of the seal stationery face with liquid soap. Using your thumbs, gently press the stationery face of the mechanical seal assembly into the discharge casing until it seats. Install the discharge casing onto the motor, taking care not to damage the seal on the stub shaft. Tighten the discharge casing onto the motor using the 4 9/16-inch bolts. Lubricate the rotating face of the mechanical seal assembly and slide it onto the stub shaft. Now place the spring over the stub shaft. Using a 7/64-inch hex key, place into the hex nut on the stub shaft to hold in place. Thread the flex joint into the rotor. You may now thread the flex joint and rotor into the stub shaft. Lubricate the rotor and interior of the stator with liquid hand soap. Slide the stator, open side down, onto the rotor and push down. The stator will seat itself into the channel on the discharge casing and acts as a seal. Install the suction casing onto the pump assembly. Bolt the suction casing down using the 7/16-inch bolts, saving the two largest bolts for the foot assembly. Add the pump foot assembly to the bottom of the pump for support. Use the two largest screws to secure. Your pump is now complete and should be leak tested using water to check the seal for leakage. If no leaks are present, please feel free to put down your tools and celebrate accordingly. If you have any questions about or require spare parts for the repair of your Liberty Process APM pump, please contact us at www.libertyprocess.com. We always have complete pumps and all spare parts in our inventory ready to ship the same day.